So guys, this is CT with CT Touch Horses /Dogs. You seen me handle Eazy a minute ago. Now this is the Eazy's owner, and I rode Eazy for her. So now what I'm going to do is just instruct her to do a few things and just watch her ride. So again, like I said, after my little 45 days or whatever, you know, it's just a good foundation for you to keep on going with your horse. It ain't nothing. Walk him around for a minute, Desi, and I want you to stop and back up. Slap him with that lead rope at that tail if he don't. There you go. Now take off walking. I do that because I don't want a horse running up a person's back. Eventually he'll learn, so that's okay if he pulls and tugs a little bit back. You know, he's not pulling backwards or anything. Stop. All right, cool. Now just turn, face him, and rub him. Bring him on over here and get your saddle on him. So when you turn and face him, then we want him to stand still, just like that right there. We want him to stand still. You see, he put his old head down. And that's not just natural stuff. That's stuff that I have taught Eazy. He's a lot easier to handle that way. So every horse you can't drop the rein on and saddle and bridle on. But most of my horses, you can. Because I teach them what the word whoa means. And if you keep going with this type of training and stay consistent with him, man, it will last forever. Because again, remember, back in December, y'all seen me roping at the national finals off of Eazy. And he fucked me out of my money. It wasn't his fault. I told y'all he was green. But man, I had a lot of money to win up there on O'Eazy. And I ended up having surgery, rotary cuff surgery. But again, wasn't none of that Eazy's fault. It was me putting more trust in Eazy than I should have, you know. But anyway, when she picked him up back in December, this lady's going through school. She's working. She's a mother. So she really just didn't have time to tend to her horse at the moment. You know, her career was a little bit more important, and I can understand that. So, but instead of her just getting on him, she brought him back to me for a tune-up. She's come back to ride him, and she'll know exactly what to do and how to continue on making Eazy a pleasurable horse. When I say pleasurable, I'm talking about a horse that she can handle, her kids can handle. She's got some beautiful kids, some handsome young men, and some beautiful little girl, and they all enjoy horses. So this horse is, he's gentle natured. He's very calm, very lazy natured. The cons to a horse like that, if you put somebody on him that can't ride, they can just spoil real easy, because he'll do what he want to do, especially being as green as he is. But anyway, see that girl? Look at them pretty stirrups, man. Damn. Ooh-wee. Shit, y'all. Look at that leopard billet. Ooh-wee. She got all that fancy stuff on him. She fancy, y'all. What's that little thing she got up there on the saddle horn? I think she keeps her makeup and shit in there. When she rides, she want to put her lashes on out there on the trail. She can. She probably got some lashes in there, don't she, Lila?
I'm helping them off at the ball field yesterday.
You know, them girls, when they get on them horses, boy, they got to look good, man. So she probably got her lashes and some lipstick and lip gloss up there in it, you know. I bet she ain't got no water, anything like that. But she got that pretty stuff. I bet she got some perfume, too. You always want to smell good on the trail. So you see, she's got her hand over the top of Eazy's head. He lowers his head down. And sometime they'll learn, they'll start figuring if they take it down lower, you'll go away. Pull that curb strap over under his lip. That's what, there though, you got it. So that's cool right there, man. That's cool. Desi.
Yeah.